And now this is the scene where Jared starts writing the ludicrous emails, and Evan's mum comes in on the discussion.
What? What's the problem?
You weren't friends with him. That's not part of the story. I was his only friend. You know that. You can't just change things. You need to redo it.
You're totally right. I mean, what was I thinking? Just making things up in a completely fabricated email exchange that never happened.
Just don't change the story, please, okay?
Well, if you want me to redo this email, you're gonna have to wait until Monday, because I have plans all weekend with my camp friends, or, as I like to call them, my real friends.
Yeah, I think we're actually good on the emails now. We're focusing on bigger stuff like the orchard and things like that.
Oh, well, I can definitely do one with the Kickstarter. I mean, I am the treasurer.
I think Alana and I are good. I'll let you know if I think of anything, though.
Got it. Hey, I bet Zoe's happy your cast is gone.
I guess.
I mean, talk about killing the mood, right? Having to see your brother's name written on your boyfriend's arm all the time.
I don't know what we are.
Don't even worry about it, bro. The only thing you should be worrying about right now is building that orchard for Connor. Because if there's one thing about Connor, the guy loved trees. Or, no, wait, you love trees. That's weird. Isn't that weird?
What are you doing?
Nothing much.
It seems like every time I come into your room, you shut off your computer screen.
Not really.
I don't know what you do on there that you don't want me to see.
I was doing homework.
Do you have a minute?
I was actually about to go to Jared's.
Didn't you go to Jared's last night?
Well, yeah, we're working on a Spanish project together. We'll be working late, though, so I'll probably just stay over again.
I saw the strangest thing on Facebook today.
Oh, really?
This video from the, something called the, Connor Project? Have you heard of that? Because the website says you're the president.
Co-president?
Uh-huh. Well, this is a video of your speech about that boy, Connor Murphy. You climbed a tree together. You told me you didn't know him, that boy.
I know, but...
But in the speech you said he was your best friend.
I know, well, that's because it wasn't true when I said I didn't know him.
So you broke your arm with him, at an orchard. You told me you broke your arm at work, at the park.
Well, who do you think drove me to the hospital? Who do you think waited for me in the emergency room for 3 hours? You at work, remember? You didn't even answer your phone.
You told me your boss drove you to the hospital.
Well, so I lied, obviously.
When were you planning on telling me any of this? Or you weren't?
When are you even here? When could I tell you?
I'm here right now.
One night a week? Some people, their parents, try to do a little better than that, just so you know.
Isn't that lucky for them?
I have to go to Jared's.
I don't think I want you going out right now, actually.
I told Jared I would be at his house 10 minutes ago.
All right, Evan. Listen, I'm skipping class just so I can talk to you. I would like you to just please talk to me.
I can't just not do some work for school whenever you decide to miss class. I can't just stop everything I'm doing whenever it's convenient for you.
I don't understand what's going on with you.
Nothing is going on with me.
You're standing up in front of the school and giving speeches? You're the president of a group? I don't know who that person is.
You're making a big deal out of something that isn't a big deal.
Evan, you need to talk to me. You need to communicate
with me.
I'm your mother.